Welcome to Analytics with Nags. This is another video in the Tips and Tricks playlist where I'm going to talk about how to use a measure as a filter. Basically, there is no issues while you use measure as a filter, but the real problem occurs like when you use measure in a slicer. That is what I'm going to talk about as part of this video. What happens when you use measure as in a filter and what happens when you use in a slicer? Let us try to understand as part of this video. So that is what I'm going to discuss here: measure in a filter pane and measure in a slicer. This channel contains a free content worth 75,000 INR or $1,000, and you can utilize this free content, which covers Power BI, SQL, MSBI, and all other topics related to Microsoft Data Analytics platform. Let's begin. So we are in Power BI now. Let me explain this simple data. So we have AdventureWorks data set, and from there we have a reseller data where I'm displaying here for each product category how much resale quantity happened. So that is what we are able to see here. And the scenario is what problem I'm trying to explain as part of today's video is, like, I want to filter out, right, if the quantity of total resale quantities is greater than or less than 50,000. So that is what I want to filter out. Basically, I want to ignore whichever total quantities resaled is less than 50K. So these two records should go away. How I can do that? So let me show you the formula. Here the count of resale, this measure, is just a sum of order quantity. So what typically I think is, like, I want to use as part of the slicer. So when I use a slicer, I cannot use this calculated measure as part of my slicer. When you drag and drop, if you see here, which will not happen or appear as part of my slicer. This is the issue people will face, right? This is what I want to show how you can achieve it. This will be the second part of the video, how we can achieve it. And let me try to explain what are the difference between filters and slicers so that you can able to understand it. Now coming to our solution, this is like you have this table, and basically if you expose this filter pane to the user, then people can able to filter from the measure itself. You can see here you have option to filter less than or equal to 50K. Here if you enter, right, then you can see you ignored, basically it should be greater than or equal to 50K. So we ignored those two categories here. So this is the very simple way that user can able to filter, and you can say, like, it is greater than or equal to or less than or equal to, you can combine. So if you want a between range, then you can use like greater than or equal to, and condition you can specify less than or equal to, something like that. So this is one of the simplest way to achieve our desired result. And one more thing I want to highlight is, like, now you see here where for individual items like this category you have basic filtering and advanced filtering options. There might be a puzzle for so many people, like, why there is no option for basic and advanced filtering here. The answer is, when you use a measure, the calculated measure, right, calculated measure in your visual, it will be like for the aggregated value for each filter context, it will be aggregated value and it will be displaying. So it will not have a underlying data with it, right? Basically, when you say like advanced or basic, it will have the data from the underlying database. These are the distinct values in your data, right? So that is what it can pick it up. For this count resale, it cannot have any distinct values because these values are calculated dynamically. That is why you will not get your basic or advanced options here. So in some scenarios, you may need to filter out what are the quantities. If the quantities, these are the aggregated value. In accessories, there can be hundreds of transactions which will be returned for one quantity, two quantities, three quantities, and it is aggregated and showing 25839. But you want to filter out only those quantities, those are resold, that is greater than 10. In that case, what you can do, you can drag and drop the base column, the underlying column in your visual, okay, table level visual. Then you see the basic formatting here. Now you got, again, you can say basic or advanced. When you go for advanced, you can filter out the less than or greater than, in our case, the 10. Okay. Now what this is happening, basically you are filtering the underlying data for the quantities who are greater than 10. Then after that, it is summing up your result over here. So these are the difference why you are not getting for your measure, the advanced or basic filtering. And if you want to filter the underlying data, you can use the base measure. Now coming to our actual solution, if you are okay with, fine with the filter pane, you can go for the solution. There is no harm in using this measure as a filter here. That is works perfect, absolutely fine. So I have this chart or visual because to demonstrate this order quantity. Here you see the order quantity base measure is used. Now here you see again you get the basic or advanced filtering. Because I set the aggregators do not summarize, as soon as you set to sum, you see again there is no option for basic or advanced filtering because again it is considered as a measure. For each filter context, it is dynamically executed. So that is why you will get it. So in order to have the same result, I mean, you do not, if you press do not summarize, you can see this will have basic or advanced filtering, and you can do your filtering based on this. So this difference you need to understand. Now when I filter greater than 10, all the order quantities that happen greater than 10 will only be appearing. This difference you should know. The second part of the video focusing on our measure in a slicer. So if you use measure in a filter, this works as usual, but slight difference you need to understand. When you aggregate, you cannot filter the underlying data. Now the second part of the video is like using a slicer, I mean measure in a slicer. So, and again, when you come over here, as we already seen in the initial video, when I use a slicer, apologies, when I use a slicer here, right, I cannot use the calculated measure, but whereas I can use your base column, okay, when it is a numeric or text, whatever, when I can able to use the column. But this is not my expected scenario. This what it is doing, it is filtering based on the underlying data 17. If the resale quantity is 17 and between 32, then filter those records, then sum it up. This is not what I am expecting. Actually what I need, basically I need to filter out after this calculation. Okay, for that there is option called what if parameter. So in modeling tab, you go to modeling and you have a name called new parameter. This is the option. So using the what if parameter, we can achieve that result. So how you can do it, you can click on this and you can say the name of this filter. You are going to create another table that will hold some values. So you might understand now what will be the values here. So let us name this one as count resale. Okay, and here you don't want to filter between minimum or maximum, just you can provide any dynamic values. This can be your based on your business need. you can set it. So how we can make it dynamically, that is later part of the video, or I can make another video. Now how much you can increment for each slice, when you slightly move, how much it should increase. Okay, so like this I will try to create a new table here. So you can see the count resale is the table. What it did, it just generated a series and then created one column here, and we can go and check this table over here, count resale. Just it will have some numbers, figures over here incrementing by 100, okay, till 20,000, till 100,000. Now in order to get this, it has generated the slicer for me. Now you can see by default it is single value. I can set the between. Okay, now when I do drag and drop our slicer, nothing happens because we didn't write any of the logic. Let me slice, slightly increase the size of this. Bear with me, I'm setting up the things. Okay, now you need to inform the logic, like when it is the value, whatever you choose here should be fall. Okay, the between these two values, these values should fall. What is the logic? I have written it to time save. So count of resale here, I have written it like measure, I think. Give me a minute. Table filter. Okay, I have written it using some other table. Basically what I am doing, if fact reseller sales count resale, this particular measure is greater than or equal to this value, because once you choose this table, you will get two values. One is this minimum value and maximum value I need to get. So it is not quantity here. I have created another table previously for testing. Now this table is nothing but count resale. Count resale, this count resale column, okay, that column. Then again I'm checking the fact resale count sales is less than or equal to maximum of this particular value. So what it will do, so each row it will check whether 2583 is greater than this value and less than this value, which is wrong, so it will not return. So we will see this table filter as part of this particular table as well. So here I need to put max. I made a mistake here, bear with me. That's it. So I can use this table filter as part of this table here. There you go. So forget about this blank, I mean because of the data. Now you can focus on here. So what it does, it gives me actual logic here. So whichever is greater than this value, okay, less than this value, which is written 1 1, even I can include this by slightly increasing my slicer, so it will become 1 now. Okay, so there is no point in having this filter over here. So what I can do is, like, instead of this, I can use this measure in the visual level filter by saying is 1. Okay, now there you go. So we have achieved our end objective. When you filter by 25, when you slice this particular slicer based on the slicer selection, it will filter the respective results. So this is how you can achieve measure in a slicer. I hope you understand the difference between how you can use measure as a filter, either in the filter pane or in the slicer pane. If you want to achieve in a slicer pane, for the calculated measure that we have created here, then you need to go for what if parameter. If you like this video, hit the thumbs up button and comment below for queries. And do remember that data is your asset.